Hello everyone, this is Gurveen here. As part of Learn Mockey series, so we have been exploring the concepts of localization and Mockey. And if we check the documentation here of Mockey framework under the framework and features section, it tells us that localization provides us the way to have localized messages or labels and also entity fields. And we can also have the string expansion inside the localization data. And we have covered these as part of the session 15 and 16 of the series. In this session, we will have a look at how Mockey provides us different methods for formatting the elements like numbers or dates. Then we can also do some currency or date time conversion. And we can also parse the number or date time values. So let us go to the IDE and we will have a look at some of the examples available in Mockey out of the box. And we'll also try to run these methods to check the behavior through a simple example. So if I go to the IDE, I have the order details screen opened here, which is part of the simple screens component. And inside the order directory, we have the order detail.xml. So the first example we will check is for formatting currency values. So currency values may be formatted differently depending on the currency code which is associated with the value. So how we can use this is we can get the localization facade instance from the context and we can use the format currency method and we can pass the value. So here we are passing the part total amount of the order part and then we are passing the unit of measure as the second parameter. So based on these values, the amount will be formatted as per this currency and the current user's locale. And we can display it as per in our application. Then the second example we can check. So another common use case is to format dates in our applications. So we have the method format available in the localization facade. So we can pass the value in the first parameter and then we can pass the format which we need to be displayed for the date value. So based on the value which is being passed here it will be the date value. The format method will execute or further call the relevant method, in this case the format date method, which can also be used directly. And the value will be formatted and displayed as per this format. So there are other methods and we will try to check these through an example service. So what I've done here is just created a simple service and we'll try to check the behavior of the other available methods of the localization facade. So we have checked the format currency. So we'll just pass in an amount and the unit of measure and we'll see how we can get the value. Then we can try to have a look at the current date formatted in a particular date format. Then it also helps to format various number or decimal fields. So this allows us to display the value of the numbers as per the user's preference. It can be based on the number of decimal values which we need or whether we need a decimal separator or not for the integer values. So here we will try to format a number, the input amount, using only one decimal place. Then we also have the parse date and parse time methods, using which we can pass the string values and we can parse the different values for date and time. Now once we change the locale, the currency value can be formatted based on the newly set locale. So we'll just change the locale inside the service and see the effect on the displayed value. So let us try to run this and see the behavior of the different methods. So Mocky is already running. So let me log in with the test user. Under tools menu, we will open services and locate our service. So let us put some amount. I'll put with two decimal places. Select a currency unit of measure. And if I try to run the service, we can see that the value which we pass has been formatted based on the unit of measure which was passed in the current user's locale, which was US. And then in the service, when we changed the locale to UK, the value gets modified and formatted in the desired output. Then today's date can be seen as per the format which we used in the service. Then this is the number formatting which we used only for a single decimal place. And then we can see the values which are parsed for the date and time strings in the relevant methods. So these methods can come in real handy when we are developing applications for, say, international users, where it is often needed that we need to format the data to display it according to the local standards. So to see more information about the various methods and implementation details, so you can check the localization facade IMPL, which gives us the details about the methods available for the currency conversion, formatting, the date time value formatting, and the parsing methods. So if there is any question, please feel free to post it in the comments, or you can use Mocky Stack Overflow as well. Thank you.